Okay, I'm back again. I'm not going to load the last video because I've just got too many interruptions. So just a little quick rundown. I've added on the trees here some cadmium green. So getting these, like this strong brightness in the light. And now I'm going to come on top with some Australian leaf green. So I've gone from like this cadmium to this dark one. Go in with some more full ground leaves. Okay, so I don't have any nice background music because for some reason I've got like this static problem with the sound, so I just have to work with me quietly. Okay. I might need some more medium here. Just a minute. I must say though that some of my interruptions this morning were very positive. Some nice people coming in and having a look at my work, and one lady's ordered a big mural of kangaroo up here, see this one? That she wants me to do that in a mural on a big wall, so that was a nice positive today. I look forward to doing that. Anyway, I'm going to be going in hard with some dark leaves. Right? So, now, what we're going to be careful of, now I haven't let this dry. I've not let this dry in between these light greens. So I can blend between the two. Sometimes I like that to happen and sometimes I don't. Just depends. So this brush, you know, like I can manipulate in different angles to get a leaf shape, you know? Some strong dark areas. So, like I was saying before, you know, like this is the light area that I want to focus on. So, all around this area, put a lot more darks, you know? So I'll pull it in tight. Okay. My reference I haven't got here right now, so I'm just winging it. Pretty much most of the time I've got all medium up my handle here. Most of the time I get the basis of the painting down. And then I just like work with what I have on the base of the painting rather than referring back to the reference all the time, because you know, like just for minor things like, you know, lighting aspects, I'll go and look at the reference, but generally I'll get the basis of it down and then just let it take its own form. So you know, like I follow a lighting pattern, and then I just let it take its own shape a bit more, right? So I don't want to paint a photograph, I want to do a painting so it becomes something different. Okay. and like I said before, like when I put the base painting on with the spray can, you know, like, and then I go over with the oil paint, eventually the whole painting will be covered with the oil paint, and that will give us that overall gloss. So the basis of the spray paint is pretty much just your background under painting, you know. And don't forget to keep standing back and just have a stand back, you know, like periodically, just to have a look and see how things are forming together. Because sometimes, you know, you can have a really nice, area, like say there's light shining through, and sometimes you can easily overwork without realising it. Because when you're working up close, it looks very different from when you stand back. So it's important to check every now and again, you know, like how you're progressing there. Generally, we're just looking at where, you know, where we have our lights and darks. Looking good? Sometimes it's easy, you know, to like paint over a bit of bedroom. You know, it's really working and then you can lose it, you know. But that's the beauty of like if you let if you let your paint dry in between layers and you go over a bit that you like, you know, not recognising it, and if you let the background dry first before you go on with the next colour, then you can wipe it off again, you know. That's why one of the reasons why I like to let it dry in between each colour. But today I haven't done that. I've put this green on, and now I'm going on with the next. So I'm pretty much not wearing it, keeps you up. At the same time, you know, you've still got to be careful not to lose what looks good. So here too, you know, like, depending on which way your brush strokes are going, so generally, you know, like I'm painting sort of like on this sort of direction, like, and that is like determining a movement. So you might want to decide on whether you want your painting to be like still, then your brush strokes would be more up and down so that the leaves are just gently falling. But if you want some movement, turning leaves to, you know, like adding a breeze as such, you know. So let's see if I can put this over here a bit. So here, like, I've pretty much like got these strokes going this way, but I'm trying to still this painting a little bit more. So I'm doing a few more brush strokes that point downwards in order to bring a stillness to the painting. Whereas if I'm going on the side like this, that's suggesting a breeze, you know, a wind, a movement. So if I want to have a very, exciting and moving painting, then I would add the breeze with the movement of the brush strokes, you know, going in a, you know, as if the leaves are moving. But if I want to have a nice, calm, peaceful, still, that's what I'm after here, really. Although I am having a softness in a breeze as well. But yeah, just depending on what you're after, you know. Pretty much I'm creating a stillness here, I think. Soften the edges, like, because the brush, the brush as well is like sort of splaying a little bit and giving more of a, you know, like brushy lines. You know, sometimes they're a little bit too much, where I just touch them and soften them down, because I don't want really to look like brush. More paint. Still looking, have a look at it. It's falling. And you can see with each, you can see with each layer how we're getting sort of like more and more depth in the painting. Yeah, well, you know, the light, it always looks different, you know, like on the camera, and the colours look different. But, you know, you still get it. You don't want to lose all that you have already put down in all those different layers. You're allowing different parts to show through and other parts you go over, and, you know. Just allow some here and there. So, and it is important, you know, like you pay attention to, like, it's important to pay attention to more, like, you know, like the denser areas of dark and, you know, filtering out to the light. Because remembering we want to pull it in, you know, pull it in. It's a bit more dark around this outside. Dense areas of bush, just allowing, you know, the copper and the gold and that to shine through also. Thank you. little bit more on this side. So we'll paint. Okay. Yeah, so I'm just closing in the canopy a bit more now. Okay, I'll leave it at that for the moment. I think I will allow that to dry before I come on with any more today. Yeah, I want a little bit of time to contemplate, right? So that always pays to, you know, just to sit back and look at your painting as you progress so that you can contemplate your next moves. Where you feel you need to have more light, where you feel you need to have more dark or colour, whatever it may be, to get a nice balance and position. So anyway, I'll leave it.